As an inhabitant of Negombo and a lover of the arts, I very much appreciate and am proud of the work of this great but little known artist, N.S. Godamanna. These are some of his works of art which mesmerized people and enhanced the faith of the Catholics, especially in Negombo.
මගේ පියා එන්.එස්. ගොඩමන්න එයා ඉපදුනේ දකුණු පළාතේ බේරුවල ගම්මානේ එයා ඉපදුනෙන් පස්සේ එහේ එයාලගේ පියාත් එක්ක ආවා ඒගොල්ලෝ දෙමළගොඩට එයාගේ ඉස්කෝලේ යන කාලේ සම්පූර්ණයෙන්ම ගිහිල්ලා තියෙන දේට දෙමළගොඩ ඉස්කෝලේ තමයි ගිහිල්ලා තියෙන්නේ දෙමළගොඩ කියන්නේ පදිංචිලා මරදානේ ලෝරන්ස් විද්‍යාලයට තමයි එයා ඉස්කෝලේ ගිහිල්ලා තියෙන්නේ
Norbert Stephen Godamanna was the youngest son in the family. He was born on the 25th of August 1914. He was a Buddhist by birth and lived his life as a Buddhist. His parents were Mr. N.J. Godamanna and Mrs. Supaya Godamanna. His father was an eminent sculptor whose works adorned many temples in countries like Malaysia and Singapore. One of his masterpieces called Vadi Gahaniya won the bronze medal in the exhibition conducted by Agriculture and Plant Society of Malaysia in Singapore.
Mage siya yat kala kadittama karala thiyenne mage piya siyat ekka Lankawet weda karala thiyenawa ya pitarat gihila weda karala thiyenawa ekenne pitrada me බුරුමේට මැලේසියාවට ඉන්දියාවට ඒ වගේ තැන්වලත් ගිහිල්ලා ඒගොල්ලෝ ඒ රටවලත් ගිහිල්ලා ඒගොල්ලෝ මේ ඒ කටයුතු කරලා තියෙනවා කියන්නේ රූපඹන එක ඒව සඳහා මේ කියන්නේ යාර සම්මාන හම්බලා තියෙනවා
He did his schooling at St. Lawrence's College, Colombo, where the principal, Mr. J.D.A. Pereira, recognized his artistic abilities and directed him for further studies at Haywood College of Fine Arts. He also studied painting at the Ceylon Technical College at Mardana. In 1953, he joined the Singala Jatiya newspaper. Later, he joined the Lake House newspapers.
එයාගේ මුලින්ම රැකියාව වෙලා තිබුණේ සිංහල ජාතිය පත්‍රයේ. ඒකේ ආර්ටිස්ට් හැටියට වැඩ කිරීම. ඊට පස්සේ ඒකේ MC කාල සීමාව කඩ කරා ඊට පස්සේ ලේක් හවුස් පත්‍රයේත් එයා වැඩ කරලා තිනවා කොහොම වුණත් එයාගේ අර මේ සුවාදීනව වැඩ කිරීම තමයි එයාගේ වැඩි කැමැත්තක් තිබිලා තියෙන්නේ ඉතින් අර පත්‍රේ වැඩ කරන කාලෙත් එයා පෞද්ගලිකව වැඩ කරලා තිනවා ඉතින් ඒකට අර පත්‍රවල එයා වැඩි කැමැත්තක් දක්වලා නැහැ ඒ කාලේ කොහොම වුණත් එයාගේ මේ ඔය ලේක් හවුස් පත්‍රයේ වල මේ වැඩ කරන කාලේ එයාගේ ඒ පින්තූරයකට එයාගේ නම දැම්මයි කියලා පොඩි ප්‍රශ්නයක් ඇති වෙලා ඒ මත එයා ඒකෙන් අයින් වෙලා තිනවා
Generally, artists are very emotional people. This incident disappointed him and he decided even to give up his profession as a painter. Then he took up photography as his field of art. He joined Wind Studio as a photographer.
නමුත් කතෝලික ආගමට අයිල්ලා තමයි තාත්තා ඒ විවාහය කරලා තියෙන්නේ. ඒ විවාහයෙන් පස්සේ පදිංචි වුණා මීගමේ ප්‍රදේශයේ. මීගමේ තමයි ඊට පස්සේ එයා ජීවත් වීම සම්පූර්ණ කාලෙම එයා මරණකම්ම ජීවත් වුණේ මීගමේ.
Negombo, known as Little Rome, is a Catholic stronghold on the west coast of Sri Lanka. Over 90% of the population of Negombo are Catholics. Negombo is also a major tourist resort in Sri Lanka. The main livelihood of the local people of this area is fishing. N.S. Godamanna was competent in several areas like painting, drawing, political cartoons, sculpting, photography, and the putting up of beautiful pandals in Catholic churches and Buddhist temples at festival times. He also designed the logos for the urban councils of Berwela and Negombo. He did many works of art, They are in different forms and mediums. Godamanna ran an art center in Don's Beach Hotel, Negombo. His paintings were very famous among the tourists who came to enjoy the beauty of Negombo.
ඒකේ මේ යාගේ ඇඳපු චිත්‍ර එහෙම ප්‍රදර්ශනය කරලා තිබුණා. එතනින් ගොඩක් ෆොරිනර්ස්ලා කියන්නේ විදේශ සංචාරකයෝ ලංකාවට ආපු අය යාගෙන් චිත්‍ර මිලදී ගත්තා මට මතකයි.
Likewise, he drew many paintings in the hotels near Negombo.
Negombo rest house එකේ තියෙනවා entrance එකේම පප්ප ඇඳපු art එකක්. මුද සහ මේ
He was also a good sculptor as his father. He was known for sculpting the torsos of people's bodies. He would take note of every detail and bring them out very distinctively in the statue. He also did some artwork in the Buddhist temples around Negombo.
මීගමේ මීගම මිනුවන්ගොඩ කොළඹ ඒ තැන්වල වෙසක් වලට ඒ තුරන් අඳිනේවා තාත්තා ඒ කාලේ කළා තියෙනවා
ආණ්ඩිය අම්බලම් පැත්තේ පන්සලක හාමුදුරු කෙනෙකුගේ පිළිමයක් ඇඹුවා ඒකත් මම දැක්කා
තාත්තා පල්ලියේ කටයුතු තමයි වැඩි වශයෙන් කරේ බෞද්ධ කටයුතු වැඩි කරලා නැහැ චිත්‍ර ශිල්පයට මහවිදී පල්ලිය එතකොට මම දන්න තරමට මොරොක්කුල පල්ලිය මොතන කුඩා පාඩුවේ පල්ලියේ පල්ලිවල තියෙන මංගල වලට තොරන් ගහනවා
He did sacred paintings in many churches around Negombo. These paintings still adorn the churches and they depict the doctrine and the tradition of the Catholic Church. However, the most important artwork of Godamanna is found at St. Mary's Church, Grand Street, Negombo. He was 38 years old when he undertook the daunting task of adorning the dome and the walls of St. Mary's Church with pictures portraying the life of Christ, which stand today as proof of the artist's workmanship. It was Reverend Father Sebastian Fernando OMI, an inhabitant of Negombo, who entrusted this work to Godamanna. He was the then parish priest of St. Mary's Church. He spotted Mr. Godamanna's talents and assigned him the task of painting the church. But he first did the marble wall in front of the altar. It was only then that Father Sebastian asked him to retouch the statue of St. Francis Xavier. Only after he had redone the statue did the priest assign him the task of painting the dome. Today, the church has become very important for the people who love art. People come together and pray to God, praising him, sitting under the paintings done by Godamanna. He painted another 12 murals depicting some important incidents in the life of Christ. They adorn the walls on the side aisles of the church. These paintings he did alone without the help of his assistants. Godamanna used Winsor and Newton oil paints as the medium for these paintings also. It took him 11 months to complete. The genius of Godamanna does not show on the murals, which any artist could do on terra firma, but on his ceiling paintings that are 72 feet above ground level. To lie on one's back on a very high scaffold and draw gigantic pictures and keeping the correct proportions is an incredible feat.
I have gone, I think, more than 1,000 times inside the church, but still, it's a, for me, of course, it's a miracle.